Okay, now I'm going to read it again. I had to cut the text in half, so points 1 to 32 are in the first video, points 33 to the end are in this video. So let's start from the beginning. Okay, now this video is a response to another video that I watched earlier today. It was a video on the body language. So I wrote a comment in the video, and I put the comment on a text so I can save them. And all this information, I've got lots of text that I wrote from comments that I've copied, that I've put on videos throughout my life, and I can gather all those and put them into one big giant book if I need to, or a bunch of small books or whatever. Okay, so here's the comment. Point number one. This is like handwriting analysis. Strokes of a pen reveal character traits. Body language also reveals character traits. I'm going to put also. Body language also reveals character traits. Change your pen strokes, it will change our characters. Change your body language, it will change our character traits. Change your thought intention, and it will change our character traits. Thus, it makes sense to become sensitive to our thoughts, so that we can attract in our life eternal respect from all creation. If we give forth the invisible intentions of respect and honor, then we will attract visible respect and honor in our life. It's the universal law of cause and effect, sowing and reaping, or the law of agreement. Anyone to whom we send disrespectful thought signals, intention, there is then no lawful agreement, but it is a legal agreement. Anyone to whom we send disrespectful thought signals, there is then no lawful agreement, but it is a legal agreement. So let's change that around so it's more clear. Anyone to whom we send disrespectful thought signals, it is referred to as, let's just change that totally. Let's just get to the point. If we send. There we go. If we send disrespectful thought signals, there is then no lawful agreement. If we send disrespectful thought signals, these signals comprise a legal agreement. But a lawful agreement is made in respect. Respectfulness. But a lawful agreement is made in respectfulness. Alright, so I just had to redo sentence number 10. If we send disrespectful thought signals, these signals comprise a legal agreement. But a lawful agreement is made in respectful. But a lawful agreement is made when we send respectful signals. But a lawful agreement is made when we send respectful signals. Okay, so let's do it like that. So you can see I am my own editor. It's easy for me to read my papers over and over and over again, and I say to myself, whoa, that's unclear, so let me retype it up to make it more clear. Sentence number 10. If we send disrespectful thought signals into the air, okay, into the air, there we go, into the air, these signals comprise a legal agreement. But a lawful agreement is made when we send respectful signals into the air. Into the airway vibrations. That's more like it. Into the airway vibrations. Okay, so let's say sentence number 10 again. If we send disrespectful thought signals, oops. If we send disrespectful thought signals into the air, airway vibrations, into the vibrations of the air, makes more sense. It's actually supposed to be as vibrations in the air. But in the airways. These signals comprise legal agreement, but lawful agreement is made when we send respectful signals into the airway. Respectful signals as vibrations into the airways. So we're still editing sentence number 10. Okay, let's read 10 again. If we send disrespectful thought signals as vibrations into the airways, these signals comprise a legal agreement. But a lawful agreement is made when we send respectful signals as vibrations into the airways. All legal agreements are entered into by way of assumption. this includes citizenship. By way of the birth certificate application bond. So I do always want to emphasize this. It is at the root, it is the birth certificate application bond. And that application is the original piece of paper that Mama signed. So that is the original bond. The birth certificates themselves, printed on bank paper, are just a title. It's a piece of paper that's a title. And so when you start to understand that in the legal world, everything has a title. In the legal world, the only thing that can be transferred is title. The title to your car, the title to your house, the title to your body. And of course, the title to your house includes the title to the land. So these are things you learn when you study law, private maritime law. So all legal agreements are entered into by assumption. This includes citizenship by way of the birth certificate application bond. Number 12. If we rebut the assumption by way of lawful affidavit recorded in the public record, then we now have the option to stand as an individual nation. Who can create their own money, which can be used in retails. In retail stores. Which can be used in retail stores. Exchangeable at the International Currency Exchange Center. Locally available in each city. So let's read 12 again. If we rebut the assumption by way of lawful affidavit recorded in the public record, or you can just put lawful affidavits, that way if someone reads it, they think to themselves, well, he just mentioned one affidavit. But there are actually two affidavits that you write up. One's a security agreement, and the other is a commercial lien. If we rebut the assumption by way of lawful affidavits recorded in the public record, then we now have the option to stand as an individual nation. Who can create their own money, which can be used in retail stores. Exchangeable at the International Currency Exchange Center. Locally available in each city. Every bank knows how to take your legal mortgage promissory note called your own legal money and exchange it for local paper currency. Of course, the bank didn't fully disclose to you that the 20-page mortgage is actually a promissory note. Is actually a promissory note. words. Paper money. Legal paper money. Legal paper money. So you can see we're adding good details on this. Okay, read 14 again. Of course, the bank didn't fully disclose to you that the 20-page mortgage is actually a legal promissory note, or in other words, legal paper money. Nor did the bank legal paper money authorized by your signature. That would be a sign of nature. A sign of Mother Nature. A sign of Mother Nature. Thus the old saying. When you see the wind blow, you know the wind is blowing. So when you see the tree bend, you know the wind is blowing. Okay, so let's read 14 again. Of course, the bank didn't fully disclose to you that the 20-page mortgage is actually a legal promissory note, or in other words, legal paper money, authorized by your signature, or sign of nature, or sign of Mother Nature. Thus the old saying, when you see the tree bend, you know the wind's blowing. Nor did the bank fully disclose that they converted your personal legal promissory note for cash and kept the cash in an escrow account for 3 years, and after 3 years wrote a letter to the IRS asking to deposit by way of 1099A, abandonment of funds, the paper money into their own account, as well as cause us to work jobs to pay the banks back with interest. For 30 years. Long story short, when you become a secured party creditor, you can draw your own paper money, even with crayon and toilet paper. Secured party creditor is just a popular name for the affidavits we can record in the public record to rebut the assumption of a legal nanny, attorney, which Mother Nature put there to teach us how to be self-regulated and peaceful safety and responsibility and peacefulness. So that's supposed to be peacefulness and peacefulness, safety and responsibility. Peacefulness, safety, and responsibility. Point 18. Legal prison planet world was created by the Illuminati and Freemasons to bring us out of the caveman killer Kilby world chaos of the jungle. There is a third step to man's evolution. It was the mind shift. which is co-creating our reality by way of lawful agreement, otherwise known as the law of attraction. The big gun and muscle was put in place by Mother Nature to force everyone to obtain a birth certificate application bond, of which the birth certificate title to the body was created. There is really only one BC bond, but for the sake of distributing Earth's resources to the people, I'm going to put one corporate. One corporate BC bond. But for the sake of distributing Earth's resources to the people in a safe, orderly method, we gave everyone their own share of the BC bond, that each individual can claim his share of that stock dividend. Which provides resources to care for his body. So if you understand that your birth certificate is traded on the stock market and it's worth trillions of dollars, actually it's an unlimited amount of money. So let's read 21 again. There is really only one corporate BC bond, but for the sake of distributing Earth's resources to the people in a safe, orderly method, we gave everyone their own share of the BC bond, that each individual can claim his share of that stock dividend, which provides resources to care for his body. We gave everyone their own share of their own. Their own stock share of the BC bond. Okay, we'll just end the sentence there and put a period, point blank. And then we'll just say, oh boy, wonderful. Individuals can claim his share of that stock dividend, which provides resources to care for his body. Resources are just shelf products, retail shelf products. Thus, you hear the word snake eats its tail. Well, that's just referring to retail. It's the products on the shelf. So, 22. Okay, so read 21 again. There is really only one corporate BC bond, but for the sake of distributing Earth's resources to the people in a safe, orderly method, we gave everyone their own stock share of the BC bond. Individuals can claim his share of that stock dividend, which provides resources, retail shelf products, to care for his particular body. That way, everyone can become a secured party creditor at their own orderly time and pace. No one tramples the door down, so to speak, like they used to do in the jungle. The strong trampled the weak, and the weak got all the worst stuff, food, clothes, protection, etc. All we have to do is learn how to become a secure party creditor. To do this, we search solutions in commerce. Listen to Winston Strout introduce you to the top system that rules the earth, called private maritime law. Put capstone system. The top capstone system. The top equal tap. Equal capstone system. Listen to Winston Strout introduce you to the top equal capstone system that rules the earth, called private maritime law. Then when you're ready to move up the Illuminati Freemason Pyramid, you can order DVD seminars and CDs, which include all the templates, reading material, and recommended subjects and books to view. I recommend at least 10 DVD seminars and single DVD called Commercial Lien, and the Paul Zaccardi DVD called A for V. I listened to them while I worked in the backyard over and over and over again. This is how I was able to move up the Illuminati Freemason Pyramid. I don't use national paper money to pay I don't use legal national paper money to pay for taxes, utilities, internet, registration, or fees. In fact, I stopped paying anything and found the commercial lien to be the hammer that drives the nail in with one blow. I had to see my lien stand and hold. So 32, in fact, I stopped paying anything and found the commercial lien to be the hammer that drives the nail in with one blow. I had to see the lien stand and hold before I was ready to pay private money, my own crayon and toilet paper. No attorney can collect from a secure party creditor, and I put it to the ultimate test by actual experience in the field. And yes, I caught TrenchFoot making my stand, but that was my own attraction, each man to his own. But the attorneys will send court papers, but keep in mind, the attorneys will send court papers and judgments against us. Test of Mother Nature. But I stood my ground peacefully. No cussing, no bad mouthing. They won't collect. They can only give the appearance of collection, but they won't touch you. It's all a test of fear to see if we will give in to the bill assumption of man and or abandon the property. Thirty-five. Therefore, Mother Nature promoted me. Now that I fully tested with real experience the power of the commercial lien against 12 banks, state tax, IRS utilities, city condemners, and county property tax, I wrote my first crayon toilet paper money and sent felt my oats standing my ground. I finally felt my oats from standing my ground. I finally felt my oats from standing my ground. And wrote my first crayon paper money. Actually, I just So, finally, I felt my oats and standing my ground, wrote my first crayon and toilet paper money. Actually, I just used my bank checks and endorsed the back as beneficiary. I wrote my first toilet paper money, crayon and toilet paper money, and sent the dishonor to the IRS CID, Criminal Investigation Division. The CID is your closest link to the big gun. And it's a friendly link. The CID is your closest friendly link to the big gun. Or international military. That's on your side when you rebut the legal assumption and become a lawful secure party creditor. Is your trust in man, legal assumption, the cerebellum, animal lower brain, or is your trust in yourself, God, cerebrum, or upper brain, or most high brain, or holy of holies, where the Ark of the Covenant is? I'll keep you up to date on my private money situation. He who enters the dark cave that he fears the most will find the greatest treasury to pay for all of life's necessity. So, there we are. Now I'll do a part three so I can get this down. So, from 33 to 38, I'll put that in this video, in the description below.